Good morning, students. Can you hear me? Is anyone is there? Can you hear me? Okay. Today I am using a new app, the Mobizen Life. If you are facing any problems regarding this app, then you can inform me. Okay? You can inform me. Clear? So today we are going to discuss about the sex determination process. So before starting the topic, before starting the linkage and recombination, we will discuss the sex determination process. First, we should discuss about the sex determination process. So what is, first we should know what is the meaning of the sex determination process. What is the meaning of sex determination process? So we should discuss all those things first. So first, scientist Henking in the year of 1891 traced specific nuclear structure during the spermatogenesis of some insect. Okay, so 50% of the sperm received this specific structure, whereas 50% sperm did not receive it. So some nuclear structure, some specific nuclear structure is absent in 50% sperm, and in 50% sperm this nuclear structure is present. So he gave a name to this structure as the X body. This was later on named on as the X chromosome. Clear? So next is the XX exotype. So this is one type of sex determination process. Clear? So what is the meaning of it? That the sex, this is the process by which you can determine the grasshopper sex. Okay, the grasshopper contains 12 pairs or 24 chromosome. In case of the human body, our total chromosome number is 46, but in case of the grasshopper, the total chromosome number is 24. It means 12 pairs of chromosome. The male has only 23 chromosome. Okay, all egg bears one X chromosome along with the autosome. Some sperms bears one X chromosome, it means the X factor, and 50% do not. This is the special type of the nuclear structure. Egg fertilized with sperm having X chromosome become female 22 plus XX. And egg fertilized with sperm without X chromosome become male 22 plus XO. That's why this type is called the XX exotype. Clear? So this is the basic overviews of the XX exotype, and this is the process by which the grasshopper sex is determined. Clear? Ankush, can you hear me? Ankush, am I audible? Can you hear me? Okay. The screen is visible properly? Okay, thank you. So in this case, what happened? That this is the process by which you can determine the grasshopper sex. And within this, if the female grasshopper is produced, then what happened? The egg fertilized with the sperm having the X chromosome. And if the male is produced, then what happened? The egg fertilized with sperm without X chromosome. So you can say that the grasshopper sex is totally depends on the male's body. Not the female body. Why? Because if the male body contains this special type of X factor, then it can transfer to the female. And if the sperm does not contain the special type of the X factor, then it transfer to the male grasshopper. So this is the basic overviews of the XX exotype, and this sex determination process is important. This sex determination process is important for your exam. This sex determination process is important for your exam. Clear? Next is the XXXY type. Next is the XXXY type. What is the meaning of this XXXY type? That the sex determination, this is the process by which you can determine the sex of the insect and mammals. Okay, what happened in this case? That the female has autosomes and a pair of X chromosome like the AA plus XX. Clear? And male has autosomes and one large X chromosome and one very small Y chromosome, that AA plus XY. So this is the basic views, or this is the basic process of the human sex determination process. This is the basic views of the human sex determination process. Clear? And in this type, male is the heterogametly and female is homogametly. Homogametly means the same types of the chromosome like the XX. But the male is heterogametly means the they does not have same types of chromosome. They have the different types of the chromosome like the XY. That's why this is called the heterogametly and female is called the homogametly. So this is the basic overviews. This is the basic overviews of the XXXY type. Clear? Next one is the ZZZW type. ZZZW type. So this is the process by which you can determine the sex of a birds. This is the process by which you can determine the sex of a bird. So what happened in this type? The female birds has two different sex chromosomes named as Z and W. Female birds, okay? And male birds have two similar sex chromosomes are called the ZZ. So you can say that the male gametes are the homogametly and the female birds are heterogametly, just opposite to the human, just opposite to the mammal's body. Clear? So what happened in this case? In the female's body contains the Z and W, two different types of the sex chromosome. So you can say that this is the process called the heterogametly chromosome, and the male birds contain only the ZZ type chromosome, sex chromosome, the similar types of the sex chromosome. So this is called the homogamete. And in this type, what happened? The sex determination, female is heterogametely and male is the homogametely. So in this case, what happened? The sex determination process solely depends on the female birds. Okay, not in the males, but because the male birds are the homogametely. Why? Because they does not have the variety in the sex chromosome. So this is the basic overviews of the ZZ and ZW types chromosome. Next was the linkage and recombination. This linkage and this sex determination in the animals is important for your board exam and your school exam, and this linkage and recombination is also important and quite difficult than the any other portion. So that's why what I am saying, please listen to me properly. So first you should know what is the meaning of the linkage and what is the meaning of the recombination. So linkage means the linked genes. Linkage means the mixed or linked genes, and recombination means the recombined together, conjugate together. That's the basic meaning of the linkage and recombination. So scientist Morgan first carried the dihybrid cross in the Drosophila fruit fly. So this is one type of the fruit fly. I think all of you have seen this Drosophila, that the blue colored fruit fly, which actually which actually sit on the fruits. So that's called the fruit fly, to study the genes that are sex linked. So crossed is the yellow bodied white eyed female with brown bodied red eyed males and intercourse F1 progeny. So what happened when he crossed two types of the male and female's body? In the female's body contain the yellow bodied white eyed females, and the male body contains the brown bodied and the red eyed males. So these two are intercourse each other, and in case of the F1 progeny, they got the gamete. Okay, so just like the Mendel's monohybrid and dihybrid cross. So next, the two genes did not segregate independently of each other, and F2 ratio divided from the 9:3:3:1. This is the phenotypic dihybrid cross ratio in the Mendel's experiment. This 9:3:3:1, this is the phenotypic dihybrid ratio in the Mendel's experiment. Clear? So the genes parent on the X chromosome and two genes in a dihybrid cross situated on the same chromosome, that's called the parental gene. So what is the meaning of the parental gene? That the genes present on the X chromosome and two genes in a dihybrid cross situated on the same chromosome, that's called the parental gene. And combination is much higher than non-parental gene. So this is due to the physical association or linkage of two genes on same chromosome. That's the phenomenon, it's called the linkage. And when the generation of the non-parental combination together, that's called the recombination. So linkage means the when two parental genes cross together, link together, that's called the linkage. And recombination means the when two non-parental genes combine together, that's called the recombination process. After that, he found genes are grouped in same chromosome, some genes are tightly linked and they are the less recombined. Why this is less recombined? Because recombination takes place always the non-parental genes. Recombination takes place always between two non-parental genes, not the same parental genes. Clear? So when genes are present in different chromosomes, they are the highly recombined. But when genes are present on the same chromosome, they are highly linked. This is the basic difference between the linkage and recombination. So in case of the linkage, what happened? That the genes are present on the same chromosome, like the chromosome number 9. Okay, so within this chromosome number 9, two genes are present. So they are belongs to the same gene on the same chromosome. They are tightly linked, but not the highly recombined. But when the genes are present in different chromosome, suppose there are two chromosomes, chromosome 9 and chromosome 10, and two different genes are present on chromosome 9 and two chromosome 10. So they are highly recombined, but not the tightly linked. So this is the basic difference between the linkage and recombination. For the recombination process, the genes should be on the different chromosomes. But in case of the recombination linkage, what happened? The genes should be on the same chromosome. The same chromosome, the same genes are tightly linked. So that's called the linkage and recombination. So this is the diagram of the linkage and recombination. This is the diagram of the linkage and recombination. Actually, all of you will get this diagram in your NCERT books and all other any other books also. Clear? So look, this is the F1 generation. The brown bodied red eyed female, this is the wild type, and yellow bodied white eyed male, this is the normal type. So this is the gametes, okay, and this is the F2 generation. This is the F1 generation, this is the F2 generation. The parental type is 98.7% and recombinant type only 1.3%. So this is the F1 generation and this is the F2 generation. Look. So this is the overviews of the linkage and recombination. So what is the meaning of the linkage? That the physical association of genes on a chromosome is called the linkage. But how they are physically associated? For the physically association, they should be on the same chromosome. The genes appearance should be on the same chromosome. So that's called the linkage. But in the case of the recombination, what happened? The generation of the non-parental gene combination is called the recombination. So this is the basic difference between the linkage and recombination. And this recombination occurs during the crossing over of the chromosome during meiosis. I think all of you have studied the meiosis and mitosis cell division in your class 11 syllabus, and there you can see that in case of the meiosis, when the prophase 1 stage is going on, in the pachytene stage, the chiasma formation takes place. Okay, so in case of the chiasma, what happened? The recombination takes place. Actually, this is called the crossing over. The mixture is takes place, and through this crossing over, through this recombination, different types of variety present in a offspring body and quite slightly different from the parents. We are not just like clones to our parents. we are not the clones of our parents. Okay, some variety is there. Some variety is there in our body than the parents' character. Okay, so that's recombination or that's variety is coming from the crossing over. And this is the basic overviews of the linkage and the recombination. Understood? Ankush, any doubt is there? Any doubt is there, Ankush? Any doubt is there? Okay, I think no. So this is the, I have made one slide. This is the, actually this is the handmade linkage and recombination process. This is the handmade linkage and recombination process, that there are two types of the chromosome. Okay, this one chromosome and another chromosome. Okay, there are some sites AABB, small a, small b. Clear? When they combine together, only crossovers happening in this small region can produce AB, A capital A small b and small a capital B chromosome. Look, recombinant chromosomes do form, but not very often. Look, this is totally blue colored, this is totally red colored. But in this case, after the crossing over, after the recombination, what happened? This portion is changed. This portion has changed. Look. The red color is present here. This red color is present here. Okay? And this blue color is present here. Look. If you see the diagram properly, then you can understand what happened in this case. Clear? Understood? Okay. So this is the basic overviews of the linkage and recombination. During the type of exam, this type of diagram is quite difficult to draw for all of you. So that's why you can draw this diagram. You can draw this diagram. Clear? So next one is the mutation. So what happened in the case of the mutation? This is the mutation means the some changes is there. Mutation means the changes. Some genetical, physical changes, that's called the mutation. Okay. So what happened in this case? That the phenotypic variation occurs due to change in gene or DNA sequence is called the mutation. And this mutation is coming by the crossing over. This linkage and recombination and this mutation is just connected to each other. This linkage and recombination, this mutation is just linked to each other, and by all those things, through all those things, the variety has come in our body. Through all those things, variety will come in our body. The organism that undergoes mutation is mutant. Clear? So, the phenomenon which result in alteration of DNA sequence and result in changes in genotype and phenotype. So, through the mutation, what happened? Some genotype and phenotype changes are there. Okay? So, there are two types of the mutation, like the loss and gain mutation. Loss means the deletion of the genes, and gain means the some insertion or duplication of a segment of DNA, result in alteration in chromosomes, or some abnormalities or aberrations are there, that's called the chromosomal aberration. So what happens? So you can write in this way, that there are two types of mutation takes place in our body, that the loss and the gain. So in case of the loss mutation, what happened? The deletion of the DNA or deletion of the gene takes place, because we all know the gene means the segment of DNA. So you can write in this way, that the in case of the loss mutation, what happened? In case of the loss mutation, some deletion is takes place in sequence of the DNA, some segment of the DNA. So that's called the loss mutation. And the gain mutation means the for the insertion and duplication of the segment. So what happened in this case? That for in case of the gain mutation, some insert the DNA segment or some duplicate DNA segment become duplicated or some inserted, some DNA segments are there in a chromosome and some abnormalities are there. That's called the chromosomal aberration. Some changes are there. If these changes are towards the positive, that's called the positive evolution or positive variation, and if this change is going to some negative, then it's called the chromosomal aberration or some abnormalities will be there. We'll discuss later part in about this chromosomal aberration or chromosomal abnormalities. What is the meaning of gene mutation? That the mutation takes place due to changes in single base pair of DNA, that's called the gene mutation or point mutation. So this gene mutation is important for your exam. Actually, this slide is important for your 1 marks exam. So what is the meaning of gene mutation? That the mutation takes place due to change in a single base pair of DNA. The mutation takes place due to change in a single base pair of a DNA is called the gene mutation or point mutation. Example, sickle cell anemia. And frame shift mutation, what is the meaning of frame shift mutation? That the deletion or insertion of the base pairs of a DNA is called the shift mutation. Like this is the gain mutation. This is one type of the loss and gain mutation. Loss means the deletion, either it will be deleted or it will be inserted, some base pairs of the DNA, that's called the frame shift mutation. So this is the basic overviews of the mutation. Okay, so in the next class, in the on the Monday, I will complete this chapter. Okay, on Monday I will complete this chapter by discussing the genetic and the chromosomal disease, some genetic and chromosomal disease. Okay, within Monday I will complete this chapter, clear? And after that I will give some study materials and worksheets. Please try to solve it, and please this mutation and linkage recombination and the sex determination process is important for your exam. All those three topics which I have taught today, all those three quite important and quite interesting to all of you, and it's important for your board exam and your school exam also. So please go through it properly, and quite difficult too. So please go through it properly, and if you are facing any doubts or any query, you can ask me anytime. Clear? I think no doubt is there, but still now if any doubt is there, then you can ask me. Okay? Okay.